हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू आवर वीडियो सीरीज ऑन फ्लाइट डायनामिक्स। दिस इज सेक्शन वन क्रूज फ्लाइट परफॉर्मेंस। इन टुडेज वीडियो वी विल गो थ्रू थ्रस्ट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर लेवल फ्लाइट। सो इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑल्सो वी सॉ दैट फॉर अ लेवल फ्लाइट थ्रस्ट विल बी इक्वल टू ड्रैग एंड ड्रैग इज इक्वल टू हाफ रो वी स्क्वायर एस सी डी एंड लिफ्ट विल बी इक्वल टू वेट एंड वेयर लिफ्ट विल बी इक्वल टू हाफ रो वी स्क्वायर एस सी एल। यूजिंग दीज टू इक्वेशंस वी मे से दैट thrust by lift is equal to thrust by weight, which is also equal to half rho v square SCD divided by half rho v square SCL. So dividing thrust by weight, we'll get thrust by weight is equal to CD by CL. So this can be written as thrust required is equal to W times CD upon CL. Now why I have used thrust required is because for a level flight, now engine may be capable of producing extra thrust, but this is the amount of thrust which is required to overcome the drag. So I am using subscript R to represent thrust required. So to differentiate it with thrust available, I am using the subscript R. So thrust required is equal to W CD times CL, which can be written as W divided by CL by CD. So this is our third equation, that TR is equal to W times CL by CD. Now we can see that from equation number 3, TR is proportional to CL by CD. So we can say that as this ratio CL by CD ratio increases, thrust required decreases. Hence thrust required is proportional to 1 upon L by D, and for minimum thrust required we require maximum L by D ratio. So in case the aircraft is flying at a setting where its L by D ratio is maximum, we can say that at that setting thrust required will be minimum. So as seen from this figure, at different angle of attack L by D or CL by CD ratio changes. So and at some angle of attacks this L by D ratio reaches its maximum value and then again decreases. So this L by D ratio is also known as aerodynamic efficiency because it basically represents the efficiency of the aircraft. So this is also known as aerodynamic efficiency of the aircraft, and the angle of attack at which L by D reaches max is generally about 2 to 5 degree for normal subsonic aircrafts. Now we have seen that from equation 1, thrust required is total drag, and we know that drag is equal to half rho v square SCD. So CD is also can be written as CD is equal to CD naught plus KCL square. Now using the value of CD in this equation, we can write drag is equal to half rho v square S CD naught plus KCL square. We know that K is equal to 1 upon pi ARE. So I have expanded this. Now here this part basically denotes zero lift drag, and this part basically denotes induced drag. So we saw this in our previous video, that what is zero lift drag and what is induced drag. Now we can see that this is the typical thrust required curve. We can see that this is the zero lift drag line and this is the induced drag line, and as the velocity is increasing, the zero lift drag is increasing and lift induced drag is decreasing. To understand this, let us first go through the formula for a zero lift drag. We know that zero lift drag is half rho v square S CD naught, and induced drag is half rho v square S CL square by pi AER. Now from the formula itself, we can see that zero lift drag is proportional to V square. So as the velocity increases, zero lift drag will increase. So this is quite clear from the formula itself. Now coming to induced drag, now from the formula we can see that induced drag is proportional to V square as well as CL square. Now let us try to understand what is the effect on CL as the velocity increases. Now we know that to maintain steady and level flight, L is equal to W is equal to half rho V square SCL. So as the velocity increases, there won't be any change in density or wingspan. So the increase in velocity has to be compensated by a decrease in CL if we have to maintain the same level flight. Which means when V is increasing by 2%, V square is increasing by 4%. So CL must be decreasing by 4%. So whatever the change in velocity would be, there will be larger change in CL. Now coming back to the formula for induced drag, so we can see that induced drag is proportional to V square as well as CL square, but we can also see that CL is changing much more than the velocity. Hence CL is more dominant in this equation. So we know that as the velocity is increasing for the same lift, CL must decrease. So as induced drag is proportional to V square as well as CL square, and CL is more dominant, so induced drag will keep on decreasing as the velocity increases because the CL is decreasing basically. And as the velocity decreases, Since the CL is increasing, the induced drag will keep on increasing. So this is the reason why induced drag decreases with velocity and zero lift drag increases with velocity. So now let us come to our next topic, which is minimum thrust required. Because we are talking about steady level flight, so minimum thrust required means minimum drag. Now drag is equal to half rho v square s cd naught plus kcl square. So from the calculus we know that this is the condition for minimum thrust required. Okay, now let us differentiate drag with respect to v. Now differentiating drag with respect to v, that means d by dv of half rho v square s cd naught plus half rho v square s into kcl square will be equal to 0. Now differentiating this first term, and we know that half rho s into k are constants and v and cl are the only variables. So d by dv of v square into cl square, this is taken into the bracket and this is taken outside. Now we also know that for a steady level condition, w is equal to half rho v square s cl, therefore cl is equal to 2w by rho v square s. So using this value, putting the value of cl in this equation, we will get this equation. Now again taking constants outside, we will get this equation. Now we have only 1 by v square inside and all other terms are outside. Now differentiating 1 by v square, we will get this equation. From this equation, we will get this cd naught by k is equal to 2w by rho v square s whole square. Now we know that this is equal to cl, so this can be written as cd naught by k is equal to cl square. From the differentiation, we got the result that cd naught is equal to kcl square, where we know that cd naught is zero lift drag and kcl square was induced drag. So the result of this differentiation is that drag will be minimum in such a case where cd naught is equal to kcl square or zero lift drag is equal to induced drag. So from this diagram also, we can see that where these two lines meet, this is the minimum drag point. Minimum drag point. Here, this induced drag will be same as the zero lift drag. So, this is the minimum drag point in the graph. Now, we can say that CD is equal to CD naught plus KCL square. That is the total drag coefficient. And CD will be equal to CD naught plus CD naught because KCL square is equal to CD naught at the minimum drag condition. Or CD will be equal to 2 CD naught or 2 KCL square. Hence, for minimum drag, CD minimum is equal to 2 CD naught, and if we find CL from this condition, we get CL at minimum drag is root CD naught by K. So these are the two important results from the minimum drag condition. So I hope you like this video. If you do, please press the like button, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Thank you for watching Concepts Unexplained.